have cancer, none of that.
No.
And you might have just walked out of a doctor's office, he told you, you are the finest physical specimen I have examined this week.
Yes.
And before you make it home, you can die. Man, I'm talking about, that's why, it behooves us, somebody said, to be ready.
Yes.
We don't know when we're going to leave here.
Amen.
Amen, man. And sometimes, I'm talking about me, sometimes we just go to sleep and think we're going to wake up in the morning somehow. Tomorrow's not promised us. Scripture says, this is the day. This is all we got. I don't know what's around with me, and I don't know what's going to happen between here and home. Amen. But I'm going to rejoice in the Lord, all right? Praise God. God is good all the time. Somebody saying there's no time that he is not good.
Yeah.
I haven't been good all the time. A lot of time I just blew it. I mean point blank.
Yeah.
I read Psalm 51 so many times.
Yeah.
Have mercy upon me, O Lord.
Yeah.
I said more many times.
Yeah.
Lord, have mercy.
Yeah.
And I say it again. Lord, forgive. I don't want, but you know what I'm saying? I was talking to somebody the other day about being honest with God, man.
Mm.
What are you talking about? Man, you were wrong, say you did it.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
What are you talking about? You can play that stuff with man. You can't do that with God.
Amen. That's right.
He said, confess your fault. Confess your sin.
That's right.
Come on, brother.
Man, you know when God saved us, he knew we were going to fail him.
Mm-hmm.
I know some people don't want to admit that. But that's why he wrote those epistles and things. Paul wrote that to the church. To teach them how to live and what to do when things arise. He wrote that to the church. They weren't written to the unsaved necessarily.
Uh-uh.
He said, my little children, he said, these things write I unto you that you sin not.
Yeah.
Now that's his first and perfect will that we don't sin.
Mm-hmm.
But he said, if we do sin, we, the saints of God, have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous. And he is a perpetuation for our sin. Talking about his people. And not for ours only, but for the sin of the whole world if they come and repent. And say, God, I'm guilty. Forgive me.
Yes.
That's all he wanted there to say. Yeah, I know you did it.
Yes.
God knows stuff about him. Don't nobody else know.
No, come on.
This is stuff, brother, we don't never tell nobody.
Say that. Help us.
God knows all about it. Those things we have said in secret and gossip. Woo.
Come on.
Oh, yeah. Whispering stuff now, folks. God, hear all that.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible said, the eyes of the Lord are in every place.
Beholding
and he can hear good, too.
Good. Yes, he can.
He can see good and hear good.
Come on,
he can
tonight.
Hear everything.
Come on,
he listens
man.
To that, too.
Preacher.
Amen. Yes, he does.
Yes, sir.
And that's why I said sometimes, you know, I hear, people talking about having a positive mental attitude and all that. That's good in a way. Brother, but it's something, you can't do it. You can tell yourself I can fly. You might meditate, believe, but brother, you jump out that mirror, you're going to hit the ground.
You better say it now. Come
I
on.
Mean, you might convince yourself, brother, but when you jump, you're going
down.
Man, but when God says something, say what he said.
Right.
I'm the redeemed of the Lord. Let the redeemed of the Lord what?
Say
so. Man, that's who I am. Somebody else, I ever preached on TV talking, you got to discover who you are. I don't know what is all that.
Come
you either saved or you lost.
That's
who you are. Right now, present tense, this day,
no,
Sunday,
no
1:42 p.m. Mm. You are saved or you are lost right now.
Yeah.
That's who you are.
Yeah.
The color of your skin doesn't mean anything. That's why I ain't never liked racism. I don't even get into that. Man, I don't care if it's getting black, white, if you're not saved, you're going to hell.
Yes, come on. Got nothing to do with race. Mm-mm.
All this racial stuff, man. Say it loud, I'm black, I'm proud. God is different to proud.
Mm-hmm. Come on,
black and white. God is against proud folks.
Yes, come on, help
us.
Yes, now preach now.
Man, he said he resists the proud.
Come
you
on,
know what
brother.
He resists, and they're like, he's pulling me and I'm pulling against
him.
Yes, and God stole him, God's going to get away.
That's right.
He said he knows the proud are far off.
Yes, yes.
You don't deal with no proud folk.
Mm-hmm.
Never.
Never. ever. Come on.
See, you gotta humble yourself.
Come on.
We're talking about the coming out of little children. Yes. You gotta humble yourself.
Yes. That's it. Come on.
Amen. Under the mighty hand of God.
God, come on. That's it.
And humble yourself. He'll lift me up. God will lift me up. Can't nobody stop him.
Yes.
Some people maneuver themselves in positions, Lord, but they better be able to lose the position. Because something they did.
Yeah, come on.
When God put it, they can't take you down. How did they get up here? They used to be on the assembly line. How did they get in there? That's what God looking for, some humble people. I'm just talking for a minute. I didn't have anything particular. I just look at God's word. I look at everybody rejoicing this morning, just thinking. Amen. God's word is so deep, brother. I mean, God's word is something.
Yes.
Man, you know what I think? God's word, you know, is a. I wrote something to somebody one time. I said, a lot of people are suffering from spiritual malnutrition. That's their problem. They think, brother, if I can get to T.D. Jakes or touch the hem of his garment or something, or get to some of these big shots like Copeland or somebody. I'm saying, you know, they say a lot of good things, but I'm saying a lot of times the problem is you neglect God's word.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when you pick up your Bible from one Sunday to the next.
My God, yeah.
Man, you know what? Just like the physical man got these beans and greens and potatoes to sustain it and get strength, the only thing will sustain the spiritual man is the word of God.
Come on.
Nothing else.
Yes, now.
Man. I mean, I'm talking, that you're talking about soul food. I'm talking about for real soul food. Not black-eyed peas and neck bone. I'm talking about God's soul food. For your soul. All they can feed in is God's word. And somehow, I don't know, sometimes while I'm working, you know, sometimes we get caught up. The job I did is a tiresome job. There's a lot of lifting and heavy lifting. It'd be hot. And sometimes I come out and be so tired, I'll come home and sit down. I cut the TV on new, but sometimes I fall asleep with my dirty clothes and stuff. I'll be so tired. And I mess around and be neglecting reading the word of God, but I try to every day, you know, as much as possible. But I'm saying don't ever neglect God's word. That's your strength.
Yes.
Amen. It's bread. Somebody says meat is milk, it's water, it's everything that we need to sustain us spiritually. Amen. Praise God. Feast on it.
Mm-hmm.
And I read this. Yes, somebody just read Psalm 23 every now and then. Man, read all of them.
Mm-hmm.
All scripture in the Bible says, given by inspiration of God from Genesis 1:1 to Revelation 22 and 21. All scripture. Oh. And you got to understand, when Paul said all scripture, he was relating to the Old Covenant. Because there was no New Testament when he was talking about that. I'm just saying something with you. Mm-hmm. You got to understand the scripture. Mm-hmm. When they were writing, when Jesus said, search the scripture, he was talking about the prophets.
Come on.
There was
New
Testament when he was here.
Yes,
he said, search the scripture. All scripture.
Come on.
Not just the New Testament. Somebody said, we a New Testament church. But I'm a Bible church.
Hey, come on.
You can't reject the Old Testament.
Nope.
Amen. Man, all scripture. Thou shalt not steal, and steal. Just valid and binding. You can't steal until I'm in the New Testament.
Come on.
What?
Help.
Amen. I don't know, but I'm just going to read something. Amen.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm going to get out of the way. I'm just lost. Praise God. Amen.
Yes,
God
is good.
Yes.
Yes.
I'm just looking at God's word. God said many things to us.
Yeah.
You go to Philippians 4:8. I'm just going to read. Lord, yeah. Let's pray. Let's pray for me, will you? That's before we go any further. Pray. Father, in Jesus' name, look upon me and help me, God, to say what you would have me to say, Lord. God, not in a carnal mind, but in a spiritual mind, God. Word my lips, God. Let your words feed your people, God, not just doing something, God, for whatever reason, but just for one reason, that your name may be glorified. I don't know what your people need, but you do, Lord. You know all things about all of us, God. You know the need. I don't. And I'm asking you to help me, God. Just be a vessel for these few minutes I'm up here, God.